The Honorable Director General, Disease Control and Prevention, Ministry of Health, and other senior officials from Ministry of Health, Yogi Ji, Usara, and team. The mayor and the Bhupati from the different cities and the districts, the chair of the Indonesian Public Health Association, Parimanta, the chair of the Association of Indonesian Public Health Educational Institute, Ibu Agustin, high officials from the University of Erlangga, the rector of the rector, director of Tobacco Control Support Center, Indonesian Public Health Association, high government official from the East Java province, my tobacco control colleagues from Captain for Tobacco Free Kids, World Health Organization, Union, Vital Strategies, and the many the people from the different parts of Indonesia, from Bali, Paramaria team, from Makassar, Bali, and the team, and from the Jakarta, so the high officials, they are here, from Bogor, from Bandung, from the Sulawesi, from the Yogyakarta, and the big team from the Muhammadiyah present here to fight against tobacco and other non-communicable disease. And ladies and gentlemen, so I would just like to share with you, the union is one of the key partners with the Tobacco Control and Public Health Program since 2007 with the Ministry of Health and many other tobacco control partners. And just as we go back for the first the Indonesian Conference on Tobacco Health is a product of the Ministry of Health and the Tobacco Control Support Center. The Honorable then Health Minister Ibu Napsi Aboy and the Pakartan Muhammad from Tobacco Control Support Center, they had a very good discussion to come up with something to discuss together, either is the conference or the workshop or seminar. Finally, both the Ministry of Health and Indonesian Public Health Association agreed to have a national conference in Indonesia in 2014. So I would like to really congratulate. Now we are on the fifth in 2018. So we have spent 5 years, in doing the many tobacco control. And every year we discuss what we have achieved, what we have learned, what we have to do, and how we have to do. So just quickly, I would like to highlight some the issue is in Indonesia, non-communicable disease, one of the major public health problems. And there are many risk factors, including tobacco, the smoking is one of the major risk factors in Indonesia. Every year, if you look at the statistics, if the smoking prevalence is growing, is increasing among the different segment of the population, so including children and women. So the alcohol consumption also is an increasing trend, and there are many other the non-communicable risk factors are also key to drive the NCD epidemic. So now is the time to act. I think we have already spent a decade discussing the tobacco control strategy, alcohol control strategy, many other non-communicable disease control strategy. Now is the time to prioritize and act. So one of them is the tobacco the control, the intervention. So WHO just estimates that in Indonesia, the non-communicable disease burden is increasing. So if you compare the statistics in 2004 and 2014, it's increased significantly. So it tells a lot of the things to us. Are we doing the right things? Or are we really uniting to make our tobacco free generation? Or are we in the right direction? So how we address these issues? We must act now. What are the Ministry of Health already identified the priority intervention to tackle tobacco control and NCD prevention. So now is the time to really implement and make an effective enforcement at the sub-national level. So here we need everybody's commitment. The media, the civil society organizations, the professional organizations, and also beyond the health from the Ministry of Finance and from the other the stakeholders. We need to be united. We need to be united. We need to tackle, we need to solve the problem. the of the NCD and tobacco in Indonesia. So just as if you look at the statistic in the top three countries in Asia, the India, Indonesia, and China. So the Indonesia remains on the second the position in terms of burden of the non-communicable disease. The India is going still there is a problem, but in India is really going to put the public health program especially on tobacco control, alcohol control, and controlling the sugary drinks and the other junk foods. So we can see in India the NCD burden is going down. The smoking prevalence also going down. The alcohol consumption, the prevalence of alcohol consumption also going down. So we can do also much better here in Indonesia. And we are here today to really be united and do the best for our people in Indonesia. So there are several things the Indonesia has achieved under the lead role of Ministry of Health. Yes, sub-national governments, the Wali Kota, the Bupati are doing really great job. This is just one of the examples I would like to give. The Pak Bhima, the mayor of Bogor City, has banned the tobacco product at the point of sale. So that's the ban of display is one of the key effective strategy to prevent the new initiation. So if the children are not exposed to the tobacco, the pack, so that really helps to prevent things. So Pak Bhima has done a great job in. And similar work has been done in Bali, in Denpasar, in Bogor, Kulon Progo, and in many other cities. So let's accelerate this, the efforts to really end the tobacco game. Another wonderful example that under the leadership of the Ministry of Health, Indonesia has established the Wali Kota and Bupati Alliance for Tobacco Control and NCD Prevention in 2011 with the 12 mayors and Bupati. So now if you look at the current status, more than 100 Bupati and Wali Kota, they are part of this the alliance. More than the 200 civil society and professional organizations are doing tobacco control now. So this is a really great achievement for Indonesia. We are already united. Now we need the action. We really need the action we have to start the action from our the home and from our society and from our community and from the city. So now the Ministry of Health, as per the Ministry of Health statistics, more than 250 the cities and the districts are doing the Kawasan Tanpa Rokok KTR. So under the effective role of the Wali Kota and Bupati in many the cities and districts, and Pak Hasto from the Kulon Progo is taking the leadership role and doing he is doing the public health politics. Public health politics is something that we need to do. What we gain, we save the lives of the people if you do the public health politics. So now we have to do the public health politics rather than the only political game. So it's a time to really help the Ministry of Health and the Wali Kota and Bupati Alliance to accelerate the tobacco control at sub-national level. What do we need to do? So I briefly mentioned the key things, but we need to prioritize. The one of the key activity is in Indonesia, compared to other countries, cigarettes are still very, very cheap. Our children easily can buy the cigarettes. When I was in Jakarta, my son, when he was 7 years old, and just he bought the cigarette with the 500 rupees or something like this. So my 7 years old, the son, has bought the cigarette when we were here. So we can think what is happening now in our community with our children. So let's make the cigarette expensive. And it's not that difficult. It's only need the political action and public health action. So Ministry of Health, together with all the civil society and partners, we can really help the Ministry of Finance and the team to increase the tax on tobacco product. What next? This is the pictorial health warning is one of the most cost effective strategy at the global level. Government doesn't need to pay a single money, a single penny to implement the pictorial health warning on tobacco pack. If you look at the Indonesian pack, I would like to bring the attention of Pa Anu. Pa Anu, I think I have presented this slide in 2015 in front of you in Jakarta. So this slide remains the same still. So my request is, the Indonesian tobacco industry, they are printing larger pictorial health warning and they export to other countries. The country in Asia and in Australia and others. But for the Indonesia, they just print 40%. Why? Why not for the larger graphic health warning for Indonesia? Why? It's an Indonesian, the right to get the right information at the right time. So what we need to do, we need to help the Ministry of Health. And Ministry of Health has to make a strong regulation to increase the size of pictorial health warning at least to 75%. We hope it's already in the pipeline, it's in the agenda of the Ministry of Health, and we believe that by this year we will achieve this one. But we need to be united. This is another, I don't know how many of you have seen this advertising at the airport in Surabaya. Yesterday, this was the big, the electoral the board there, and look at the type of advertising that the tobacco industry is doing to market, to place their product in our community. So they use the difference, the group. Now they are targeting the women, they are targeting the children by doing the different the marketing tactics in Indonesia. So we have to ban the tobacco advertising, promotion and sponsorship. Sorry to mention here, Indonesia remains only one country in Asia, in Asia Pacific, where only we can see the tobacco advertising. If you travel in any other country, please believe me, trust me, you don't see any billboard or any iklan of tobacco and alcohol as well. So now it's a good opportunity for all of us. So in public health program, nothing, we are not too late. So we are at the right time now, let's act now. And it can be done by the sub-national government, by the party, by sector, by the Walikota, by the university. So if we do in our own place, so we can see on the Indonesia. Very simple, as it doesn't need a huge investment. So the other thing is Kawasan Tanpa Rokok is really expanding at the sub-national level. We need more. We need to engage the Walikota and Bupati Alliance and the stakeholder at the sub-national level to really create the smoke-free environment in each and every other places so that we can offer a good and the healthy air to our children and the people. The last but not the least, I would like to just say that whatever we do, tobacco industry always with us. Tobacco industries are closely monitoring the activity of the Ministry of Health and the partners. All the time they do. And their only the tactics is to stop any the good implementation or any good legislation or policy. So this is the slide, if you look at this, how the tobacco industry consider or see the Indonesia. They see Indonesia as a growing market. They mention it in their website. It's not my word, it's not. Just I copy and paste from their website. They mention Indonesia as a growing market for them. So they mention also in other ASEAN countries, there is a very strict law, rules, regulation. So they have very limited opportunity to market the product in other countries. They mention that. But in what they say, in Indonesia, there is no such regulation. So they see this is one of the fertile the land for them to market their product, to attract or to capture, to tap our children. So if we are talking about the tobacco-free generation, we have to do something differently. We have to prevent the tobacco industry interference in policy, the process, and also in the implementation process. And their role is to implement only rules and regulations. So I talk earlier about the partnership. We have to foster the partnership. We have to gain the public support. And we have several stakeholders working already in this work. the Tobacco Control Network, Public Health Association, Medical Association, the Walipur Anupati Alliances, and the media also are doing the excellent job in Indonesia. The civil society organization like the NU and Muhammadiyah has also been a part of this movement. So we can deliver the best. Indonesia can be the leader at the global level, at the regional level. So there is a lot of potential, and just we need to act now. So just I would like to conclude with this sentence. Our future is not written. Nobody has written our future, and nobody will write the future for our people. It's we have to write a future for our generation to make a healthy environment. So it's always we please don't miss the opportunity. This is our wonderful time. We can deliver something. Whoever we are, wherever we are, we can do tobacco control. Even in the house, we can do tobacco control. We can educate our children. We can educate our family. So wherever we go, we do tobacco control. We do public health program. We do exit program. My sincere request, the first thing is we have to prioritize the activities. That is first my request to Pa'amu and the team, especially and all pictorial health warning is one of the best opportunity for Indonesia, and Indonesia can really take a lead. Not only the 75% can go beyond the 90%, because I have shown you the Indonesian industry already printing 90% pictorial health warning for other countries. So it can be done also in Indonesia. What we need is just regulation. And the union, we are always with you and we will remain with you, and our goal only to create a problem, the healthy environment in our society. I would like to thank all and thank you very much.